Hey now, welcome folks. Thanks for joining us on EVL TV this evening for a little bit of UGC Platinum Highlander action between Silver Savages and DK, also known as Dunning-Kruger Effect. My name is Gex. I have Grizz, my long-lost friend, alongside me, as well as Dashner on production. Grizz, you've disappeared off the face of the planet, buddy. How you been?
You know, I've been good. I've been enjoying a TF2 free life, but I'm back. I was asked to cast tonight. I'm excited. It's always good to be with my pal Gex and, of course, the one and only cameraman of legend, Dashner. So excited for what should be a really good game tonight.
Yes, we can only hope a really good game. You know, we've got some good Viaduct action, which is always my favorite map to cast and watch across the board, whether it be Sixes or Highlander. It always makes for some pretty exciting gameplay nonetheless. So I am quite hyped for it. Like I said, we have Silver Savages and DK going at it tonight. And, you know, just as I look at the rosters here, the guys that are in this server, what are you thinking right off the bat for, as I guess a prediction, really, just throwing it out there right away, Grizz?
All right, well, I mean, I'll be the first to admit I haven't been keeping up with this season as well as I have seasons in the past, but I'm going to go ahead and go with Silver Savages. I think that we're kind of, from what I see, we're kind of in that transition period where SS is an up-and-coming team, puts a lot of effort into Highlander, plays a ton of the game, you know, outside of competitive. They're still surprisingly having fun with it. And I see DK as a team that's, you know, riddled with some problems as far as, you know, obviously they have some extremely strong veteran players who are going to be huge impact players today's match, but I just see them as a team on the downslope as we start today's match.
Yeah, they definitely have a lot of talent, DK, but you know, I feel as though a lot of their players are very focused on Sixes as well. A lot of them play at a high level in ESEA and things like that, so it should definitely make for something interesting here. Jaxter tries to go for a bomb right off the start. That is completely denied. Patty's really hurt over on the side as well. Course is able to find one. Few frags going down. Huey Lewis falls as well, but it's actually two players down apiece at the moment. Corsa goes down, and Akuma is lurking on the backside. As it seems as though, actually, both teams are just about even in numbers. Nonetheless, Carl's starting to back up, though, a bit on the side of DK. Banny's still in, but Carl just took a pipe as we speak, so he's going to have to back up, and Ski's got taken down by Patty, which is a big pick. As long as Carl can stay alive here, they're going to have full advantage.
Yeah, actually, nobody capped the point there. Some really nice plays. Rolls Royce from SS doing a nice job of shutting people down. Corsa and Feroff are both getting a pick at the start here. So looking pretty even right now. Looks like Invader's trying to get some time on the point, but Carl's going to be coming in with the supercharge any second.
Ooh, Jaxter tried to come in as well to find a little something, but that Uber did get popped off by Carl. They found a few frags now. Godwash, Jaxter, Rolls-Royce, all those guys going down. So they are trying to get the point finally. Still nobody's capped it up yet, but it looks like DK might grab it. They got a lot of time down onto the point. Both sides are down three players at the moment, and they are pretty steady on this point here. So they do finally get the cap. DK does. And Patty's going to go down as well as a few others on the side of DK, and Akuma's causing a little bit of disturbance over on the cliffside, but Silver Savages looking like they're going to grab this point back.
Yeah, actually really surprising that DK couldn't get the point there. It looked like a nice Uber, but Mooma unfortunately got dropped there, which made it a little bit less successful. We'll see if they can't take a little bit better care of him, but Farrowoffer taken down, Corsa, and Banny goes down as well.
So they do pop this Uber off. Jaxter's going to go straight on in the Carl, takes down the medic on the side of DK. A good jump. He's actually using, I believe he's using the base jumper, Jaxter is, which is a pretty interesting choice in loadout, but he managed to get the medic, so no harm done there by any means. It's a big pick for them. Of course, he's going to find Godwash with a snipe, but that's going to leave Skies with a little bit of advantage to work with here, about 20% or so. And Silver Savage is still in control of the point here. Corsa goes down. Pharaoh Affer's on a 5k right now on his life. And DK is trying to grab this point back if they can. They got some good time down. Skies took a lot of damage. So he's got to back up. Actually found an arrow frag onto Akuma. But the point does go back in favor of DK here.
Yeah, nice soft push there from DK. Doing a great job. Mooma getting a ton of damage out. there to really allow some frags to go in DK's favor. And we're going to see him take this point.
Ooh, there comes the snipe from Pharaoh Aphra. That's six for him on this life. Uber gets popped off. They send Jaxter in, trying to move Godwash and Invader forward as well. The counter Uber comes through from DK. They save Mooma this time, just barely. But a couple frags coming through on the side of Silver Savages. Mooma, Jordan. I think I saw Banny go down there as well. Yes, they're down quite a lot of players. Carl's going to go down as well to a pipe from Invader. And, well, that's going to be just about all she wrote for DK, at least for now. So they're going to have to back up. Silver Savages has the point.
Snipe onto, I believe it was Zan there. Heavy going down for DK. Pharaoh Aphra doing a great job getting tons of heals and doing a lot of work with them.
Indeed he is. He's wreaking havoc right now. Currently at the top of the scoreboards on the side of Silver Savages. And they have a pretty large advantage, speaking of which. They're trying to make a push back towards the point. DK is here. And they have an Uber to work with, Silver Savages. But they allow DK to pop this point. Or grab this point, excuse me. And they pop the Uber off finally. But not in time to save the point. DK is down quite a bit of players, though. Zan, Patty, and Corsa out of the fight here. As it looks like Silver Savages are going to be able to grab this point back, though the Uber from Carl should be coming through here relatively soon. He's sitting at 75%. Akuma's going to finally finish off a Pharaoh after there, who's been having a pretty hot start to the game so far. But DK is on the point here, getting the cap time down, and looks like they are going to be able to grab it. Though they do get a bomb in from Invader, trying to stop it if they can. Actually got the Uber force there. I think it was him that got that force onto Carl. Not sure who else contributed, but they got it nonetheless. They have the point. And looks like Silver Savage is going to be looking to re-push here soon. And Skeez is up at 95% on the Uber at the moment, so they're going to be looking to come right back in.
Yeah, I'm expecting a big bomb from Jaxter here. He's been doing a good job there. The Uber is popped from Skeez as he goes in looking for some frags, but can't quite find Carl.
Pharaoh Aphra is taken out by Akuma. As you said, they did pop the Uber off. They got a lot of good damage off onto some guys over on the cliffside from DK, but Silver Savages is down three players at the moment. They're dead even on time at the moment, but DK has time down onto the point. Jaxter's actually taken out by a body shot from, excuse me, from Corsa. And the time is just continuing to tick down here from DK, so Silver Savage is going to have to make a move here. Carl has the Uber, though, so it's going to make this push all the tougher. They really need to try and get a force out of him if they can. They do indeed. They're trying to send Banny forward, see maybe if they can grab Skeez, but they're doing a good job of denying him. Very good job of denying him here so far. Jaxter's going to come in from behind, getting some damage off. He's able to take down Carl on that post Uber, which is a big pick for them. DK still has control at this point, though. Silver Savages need to get on it. Or excuse me, they have the point. Get a little confused there, Grizz. All right.
Yeah, you know what happens. I don't know. I'm just really surprised. I've been watching Rolls-Royce, who is just railing off headshots right now, just demolishing anybody who's out of position. Excellent job of just being a constant threat, which is so hard to do as a spy. You often rely on getting that big pick, but here comes the Uber out of Skeez, looking to get in on the combo. Huey Lewis getting caught out by the scout.
As you said, they did pop it off. Carl's now going to have about a 30% advantage. DK's working over on the cliffside. We see Invader. He decides to jump in. He might lose his life because of it. Indeed, he does. So that'll be Demo Man down on the side of Silver Savages. Not sure if that was a unnecessary play. Rolls-Royce comes in. He is going to get that backstab onto Zan. That's a pretty large pick for them. And it's almost time up for DK here. They're very close to capping this point, so they do save it with just 5 seconds. But Silver Savages now on the ropes a bit. They're going to have to move in shortly. Carl is just coming up on the Uber right now. And Skeez is only at 70%, so they're going to have to make a move here once they get this Uber. They're going to got to go right away. I don't even know if they have time.
A nice pick onto Banny, though. He's such a threat to deal with on the flank. It's a really, it's a scout, but it's still a great pick to move in on. He's dealing tons of damage this game, and the Ubers are both exchanged out of Carl and out of Skeez.
So they're going to have a battle on the point. Silver Savages absolutely needs to win this fight. That is a big headshot out of Pharaoh after taking down Zam. And Rolls-Royce is going to find one on the course as well. A lot of time down onto the point for Silver Savages at the moment. Frags being traded across the board here. Banny's finding frags. That's a 3K for him. He's going in. He's going to find another one. That's 4 for Banny. Huge stuff from him. He might just single-handedly win it for DK right there. Indeed, he did right at the end of the round. Massive 4K from him to finish it off and give DK the 1-0 lead.
Yeah, honestly, there were some pretty nice plays there. Jordan, doing an excellent job there playing engineer for DK. Good to see him back on his original class. It's a sight to behold for me. But here we go into the second round. We'll see if they can hold Banny back a little more. He did so much work in that last round.
He really did, especially at the end there. That was big. Oh, no, Carl's going to go down right off the start to Invader, and a lot of frags coming through from Silver Savages at the moment. They only have four guys up. The rest of them, they're trying to back up. Corsa went down, and you have Muma over on the cliff side. He's just hanging out waiting for some respawns, but looks like we have one of those nice little pauses going. My favorite. Oh, good. Dashner's telling us to talk about ye old Uncle Dane, who I believe both of our engineers, at least on your screen, are renamed to Uncle Dane. So you have that pleasure, and that's what they were. Do they still have the avatars is the question. Both of our engineers. No, they did at one point. They had they were trying to pull off the Uncle Dane alias. And they had the Steam avatar and everything, but they've changed it up on us. I'm a little bit disappointed because I first saw Uncle Dane come into the server and I was quite happy, and then I realized that's probably
not the case. Too, so it's really, you know, it's a sad time. I really expect a celebrity to be making an appearance tonight, but I guess we'll all just have our hearts broken by cameraman Dashner here.
Yeah. And I'm getting our hopes up and just shooting them down. I was expecting a top frag out of Uncle Dane as well. Some big NGDM, but alas, we are disappointed.
Yeah, we're left with Muma and Banny instead of Uncle Dane.
Yeah, who wants to see that?
Nobody is more disappointed than the casters tonight, guys. So we are sorry for that. But, you know, pretty good game so far. Very close first round. I actually forgot who won it, so I just had to check my scoreboard. Great job, DK. Really solid. Obviously, Banny picking up a huge couple frags at the end there. I thought that getting the pick on him would have been helpful, but they just didn't push fast enough. And when he had the respawn with the buffs, too much for SS to handle.
Yeah, that was crazy what Banny pulled off there. I mean, pretty much, like I'd said before, towards the end of the round there, almost single-handedly won it for DK there. It was a very, very big play. So that does put them up at a 1-0 lead, but really close round nonetheless. Silver Savages was certainly in it, and they had the opportunity to win. It was just that that play from Banny just made things so difficult for them, but certainly still in this one. I mean, it's been a back-and-forth battle throughout the first round. You know, you have Pharaoh Affer, who's really been doing some big work. Course has been quite quiet so far on the side of DK. So, you know, we'll have to keep an eye on that as time goes on. But Pharaoh Affer really has been doing some good work on the side of Silver Savages. And Godwash, too, has been doing quite well. Scouts, definitely a presence. This is a very friendly map towards Scouts and Sixes and, same of Highlander as well. You can definitely do some pretty good stuff. It's a little playground for the Scouts to work with. So,
yeah. Doing... As soon as you get that mini sentry down, it's a playground. Before that, it's kind of like a playground, but all the wood chips are like really sharp, and you don't really want to go down the slide or have fun in general. So,
yeah, you're gonna cut your knees up a little bit.
Yeah,
or something.
Gotta get
the, take
those
a mean
horrible
fall.
Scrapes.
Yeah, but once you get your pals to clean up those wood chips a little bit, maybe sand them down, get rid of the mini sentry, then.
This analogy is going really well. It's going really well. It just got better and better. You know,
I hope everybody appreciated that.
Honestly, it's just good to see two good teams going head to head. It's from what I understand, it's been a really interesting season of Platinum, and this is one of the most anticipated games. So I'm happy to be here with Gex. I'm happy to see Uncle Dane, and we're unpaused.
Oh, hallelujah! Because I was just pretty much running out of things to talk about, if you couldn't tell. So. We're right back into it here. So it's kind of a waiting period really for both these teams, and our HUDs are broken, so until we retry in console, so I'll try and work with it. So, as Dashner yells at me. But anyway, Rolls Royce goes down to a pipe from Mooma, and he actually just got, he had his, you know, his little, he just feigned out a little bit, but it looks like Skis is going to pop this Uber off onto the point here, and they're going to find some frags, but they're also down a few, and the respawn should be coming through soon. They're hanging tight on the point. DK is just getting their respawns now to try and work back up with, and it looks like they'll be making a push from that cliffside here soon, if they can get out.
Yeah, I mean, interesting play there from the blue medic. I'm sure he got forced, but looks like they're going to have to make a play right now. As I say that, Akuma getting skis. I mean, great work opening up an opportunity like that for his team. Excellent job by DK pressuring that medic.
Yeah, that's a really big pick. That's exactly what the doctor ordered, as they say. And that also leaves Carl with a full advantage to work with. Silver Savage is down a lot of guys, so they're just going to have to wait for the respawns, and which they're starting to get right now. And they'll be looking to make a move here soon, but they gotta do something about Carl's Uber. I mean, Skis is building it up, and he's at 30% now, but they're gonna have to do something about Carl, or just wait it out and try and build up this Uber some. But just kind of a stalemate period right now. Rolls Royce was shot up once again. Jaxter's gonna go in for a bomb. He got one good rocket off onto Carl, but couldn't quite secure the rest of the frag. So Patty and Zan are down. Invader and Jaxter are down on the side of Silver Savages. So it's a pretty even fight at the moment, but Silver Savages finally have their Uber up now, and it looks like they're going to try and make a move here as they get that Invader respawn. And they're making their move towards the point right now. They're standing on it. DK not really making a move back. Corsa gets a big pick onto Invader, though. And Jordan's going to find Godwash. That's another... He's on a 5k right now. But both Ubers get exchanged on the point. Silver Savages still has yet to cap it off. And they've lost a few guys. Lazy and Jaxter both down at the moment. And they have so much time down here. They just need to finish off the cap. Angry Officer does manage to do that, and I just hear headshots all over the place. My. Between the Spy and Snipers, I keep hearing the headshots ring off, but Silver Savage just has the point. So...
destroy the backfield, but Godwatch, aka I believe it's Train, is just going ham right now, taking apart DK's flank by himself. Excellent DM, and I know having a really great season and showing off tonight.
Well, DK, they're behind a bit on advantage here. Skis is just actually up on his Uber right now. He's hanging over on the cliffside, and Rolls Royce, well, he's just going to feign out, actually. Didn't get fragged, but DK's looking to make a move towards the point right now, and they're going to take this Uber into DK, actually, who still has yet to get their Uber. They're at 90%. They're able to find a couple of frags. Mooma, Jordan, Akuma all down on that side, but Silver Savage is going to lose a few as well, and they managed to keep Carl alive, so they should be able to come back in with this Uber very shortly. They got the Mooma respawn as well as the others, so they're definitely going to look to move with this. Carl meeting up with Mooma right now, and they're going to look to take this point back, but Silver Savages has a pretty big time advantage on them right now, but DK just standing on the point. There's really not all that much that Silver Savages can do to try and contest that, so they're just going to get their respawns, build up the Zuber, and try and push back in.
Bomb coming in. Jaxter looking for a frag, gets shut down by Banny, who just takes him right out of the sky. Duck Hunt. And honestly, I don't really know. It didn't seem too coordinated from my perspective, but maybe Jaxter was just hoping to get lucky.
He's been somewhat successful. I think he's gotten a few times he's found the frag on a Carl, and he's done a pretty an okay job, even though he is sitting at the bottom of the scoreboard. Just as I say that, I was trying to give him a little bit of credit, but actually the Uber's going to get popped out of Silver Savages. They just try and send it forward. I don't know if they miscalculated the Uber advantages and tried to catch Carl off quick before he had his. I mean, they exchanged, so there's not really all that much harm done. Huey Lewis and Zan both down, but Silver Savages losing players like crazy. Banny's on a 5k. and they are in a bit of trouble here. DK should be able to hold on to this point, it seems, quite easily, and Silver Savages, they're still in the lead on time, but they're going to have to make a solid push here soon, or DK's going to go up 2-0.
Yeah, Corsa seems like he's finding his level, right, as I say that Jaxer takes him out, but Corsa seems to be kind of finding him his aim in this second round. Struggled a little bit in the first, but has been getting some 2-3 frag streak. And...
oh, they're close on it. Oh, actually, Carl's going to go down. Angry Officer, a.k.a. Uncle Dane, as you see on your screen, found that frag on a Carl, and it looks like they're actually going to finish off the round there and tie this game back up at 1-1. Got that cat back, Silver Savages. So we got a game here, Grizz.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't surprised to really see it being a competition, but I mean, this is extremely close, and I'm glad that they took a round so I don't look like an idiot predicting them in the start. So good job, SS. Corsa doing a nice job of starting it off with a headshot onto the Blue Heavy.
Godwash is able to find Zan as well off the start here, and as we take a look, Banny's getting, oh my goodness, that's 3-4 frags from Banny right now, and Invader's gonna find Carl as well. Banny is off to a hot start on this round. He's looking for more as well. He got a lot of damage off that Patty cleaned up on, taking down Skies and Invader. Banny leading that charge once again and gives DK the point first.
Yeah, I mean, wow, huge kill participation in that from Banny, just taking apart the flank, moving into the combo, getting a ton of damage off, and then Patty coming in to clean it up. Awesome job by the DK flank. We'll see if SS can respond to a commanding performance like that.
And Banny is just such a force to be reckoned with right now for Silver Savages. But Corsa's going to find a few. He gets Invader and Rolls Royce, though they do get this point back nonetheless, so they're trying to make up for lost time here. They have a slight advantage in the Uber department, and DK's got to wait for their respawns. Silver Savage is down Invader. He just got his respawn as well, so kind of one of the stalemate periods here. Just both teams waiting for their respawns. Excuse me, my goodness. Both teams waiting for
settle
their respawns.
Down,
yeah, I'm getting a little too excited here. But Muma is up on... well, actually, oh no, the crits is going to get popped off. Carl was running crits. He finds three. Muma does. That's some big stuff out of them, getting that Chris Krieg off. Caught him off guard with their pants down and nearly a full wipe on the side of Silver Savages. And that will allow DK to just waltz onto the point and get that cap.
I don't know who made the call, but it, I mean, excellent work by Carl switching to Chris Krieg. I was not expecting, I'm guessing that SS wasn't either based on their positioning. And a huge play there, getting, as you said, just a total team wipe. Absolutely great performance by Muma there.
That was just what DK needed, and they're going to give them or set themselves up quite well right now. And oh, there comes a drop out of Corsa, getting the full body shot. Full body shot onto Skies there. And, well, nonetheless, they're actually going to be able to cap up on this point. Feral Afters on a 5K. Right now, actually make that 6. Takes down Corsa as well. And 7 gets Zan. Going nuts. And despite them getting their medic, they were able to get the point back, even though it was only momentarily. They lost a lot of guys afterwards, and they're getting their respawns now. And just kind of hanging out, waiting to make a push.
Yeah, right now, Muma did a great job with that crit streak. Feral effort, great response. Just what SS needed was a little bit of pressure onto DK, stop that aggressive hold that they had going. Muma taking down Invader, no demo man for the blue team on this push.
That's going to make things much more difficult for them, for sure, as they're down about a minute on time right now. And actually, that's going to be crits popped off once again here. Muma trying to find something, but not going to find anything. And actually, Feral Affer takes down Muma. So, and DK loses nearly everybody because of it. Carl and Huey Lewis, I think, were the only two to survive. They're getting their respawns, and Huey's just running away desperately. Oh, no, God boshed him. He was just yelling help, but couldn't find the help. Nobody around, so Silver Savages, they got the point. They're chilling. And they have a full Uber too, Grizz.
Yeah, I mean, oh, and they're forced, though, Mooma with a great bomb in there to get the pressure onto Skies. Of course, it takes down Invader, so again, Demo dropped, and some frags going in the way of DK right now, actually.
Skies didn't act, or I don't know if he ended up picking up maybe like a sandwich or something that was on the ground, but when I saw him, he wasn't actually all that low on health. I don't know if it was a weak pop or not. I didn't see the whole encounter take place, but nonetheless, it is a force, and... Well, Mooma's going to get taken out of this world by Pharaohaffer, who's still just been red hot here so far on Sniper throughout this game. And Silver Savages, they have the point. Pharaohaffer's going to find another one, takes down Zan. He's finding some really crucial frags for Silver Savages here. But DK definitely looking to make some sort of a move back towards this point soon if they can. But the thing is, they're down quite a bit in that Uber department. Skies has a full one to work with, and actually, which they're going to pop off right now. They're trying to send it forward. They haven't found much of anything with it. And DK is actually the one finding frags at the moment. Patty kills himself, and they lost a few others on the side of Silver Savages. So, well, it looks like they want to move in with it now, as they are sitting at 90%.
Yeah, positioning from DK, getting a little bit more aggressive here. They're in position to use this. They really want to get the frags onto SS and buy themselves another good chunk of time. Huey Lewis is going to go down to Invader with a good bomb in. And they force the pop, I think. Oh, no, they still have it.
Yeah, they're hanging tight with it. Corsa gets Jaxter. And Rolls Royce is... he's going to have to faint off because of Jordan's mini sentry. So Skies, who is at 90%, is getting ready to make a move right now. And they gotta go quick because it's almost time up for them. And it's crits against Uber, I believe that was. Or something. Either way, two Ubers get popped off. Carl goes down. Mooma, Patty, the whole lot on the side of DK. Actually, a lot of frags coming through from both sides at the moment. Banny, who was on a 3K, was able to find Carl, so it's actually a tight fight on the point right now. There's not a lot of heavy classes up there from Silver Savages. DK is trying to get right back onto this point here. They'll have better respawns, and things are looking really bleak for Silver Savages. DK is going to have a strong point presence here, and they have a lot of time down onto it as well. They gotta stand on it, but there's just not enough bodies for them. And DK had those respawns, Grizz. It just, they got to the point much quicker and were able to cap it and defend it. So that'll give it a 2-1 lead for DK.
Yeah, just as Banny made some nice plays in that first round, hats off to Uncle Dane, Jordan in that second one. In that last play, doing a great job of holding the point down for DK when it looked like his team was all but defeated. Of course, is starting off this new round, though, with another headshot.
So, let's hop right into it. This time, Banny wasn't able to go on a spree. Akuma comes in and takes down Skies, though. That's a big start to the round for DK. A really, really big pick. Carl is up on an Uber right now. It's actually Kritzkrieg, so we'll see. Trying to keep Mooma alive here, who ended up getting quite damaged. Carl's very, very hurt, and actually, Mooma went down, and the drop is going to come through. There wasn't really much for him to pop it on, but Invader found two frags. One on Demuma, one on Carl, and that's a big response for them. DK just about to cap the point, but they actually have reinforcements coming through, Silver Savages, and they're able to hold off the point. Oh, DK was just a hair away from capping it, but they do have guys coming through now that'll be able to finish it off.
Yeah, Train right now just finding all the frags, cleaning up Patty on the flank. Being a just presence all over the map, that is Godwash, I believe, on my screen, but he is doing an extremely good job of keeping up with Banny on that scout role.
Really is, and Banny's been quite a presence, but as you said, Train or Godwash has really been keeping up, actually has more points than Banny at the moment, but the Uber is going to get popped off from Silver Savages. They're trying to send it forward. They're moving Godwash through. Patty goes down to Pharaohaffer, who's on a 4K. Once again, Jaxter comes through, finds a couple, and, well, Akuma's going to clean up on Pharaohaffer, but Silver Savages down quite a few players at the moment. They've kind of had to back up here. Skies and Angry Officer just chilling, and DK will grab the point.
Excellent job by Huey Lewis to stop the pressure onto Carl. They had a couple of classes in, and he just kept his cool, pressed mouse 2 a bunch of times, and magically his medic was saved. So excellent job by Huey, just being aware and protecting his medic buddy in Carl.
As we take a look at Ubers, Carl is at 100%, and Ski's still trying to build it up here. Jaxer comes in, forces the crit streak out of Carl as Muma's trying to find something. Actually, was able to find Ski's with a crit sticky. Gets Traylan as well. Big stuff from Muma. I didn't think he was going to be able to find anything with it, but he did. And the biggest pick of all onto Ski's. So good stuff there. They weren't in the best position to use that crits, but they made it work for sure. Akuma comes through and finishes off Invader. DK is going to stay strong on this point right now as Silver Savages has to regroup and see what they can work for a push here.
Yeah, nice job by Muma there for all the flack he gets for his attitude. He definitely performs and is performing tonight with 84 points and just absolutely ripping apart Silver Savages. But I have to give it a hats off to Rolls Royce, who has got to be making Corsa have the least fun he's had all season. I just see him do nothing but rail off headshots as the crit is popped. Looking for frags, can't seem to find any, gets the heavy, but a lot
ooh,
of pressure.
Akuma got skis, though. Oh, no. That's disastrous for Silver Savages. Akuma comes through and gets skis once again, and this round is it's getting tougher and tougher here for Silver Savages, but they're keeping things close as far as time is concerned. They've lost skis quite a few times here on this round, but they're hanging tight, and Carl actually went down too. I don't know what it was, who killed him, but somebody got him, so that's good if you're a Silver Savages fan for sure.
Yeah, nice job here. We're kind of getting a little bit back to an even kind of hold. Corsa looking to get some sort of aggressive pick here. He's very far forward on the point. Pharaoh after doing the same from Cliffside, and Corsa goes down to Jaxter, who just jumped right on him, getting that sniper out of the way early.
Big reflect came through from Lazy on the Patty as well, and well, that's going to be Silver Savages back onto the point. They're keeping things even right now, really they are, and Skies does have some advantage in the as far as Ubers go, but DK looking to make a push, and Vader goes down, and Corsa gets Lazy as well. Two big headshots, and now that'll be DK right back onto the point, keeping themselves in the lead as far as time is concerned. They are up 2-1 as far as rounds go as well, so looking to make it 3-1 going into this half, and the Uber was forced out of Silver Savages all the way back on the cliffside. Not a good position for them to have to use that Uber. That leaves Carl with full advantage, just sitting back on the cliffside here, and it's going to be very difficult for Silver Savages here. Got to get this force out of Carl, and actually they just decided to take it right into Silver Savages. Skies, who is really, really hurt, should go down to Banny here. I would suspect indeed he does, and that will leave them hurting for sure here, Grizz.
Yeah, and DK seems to have found their stride. I mean, I regret making a little bit of a negative comment about them at the beginning. But again, they're doing a great job of it. They're adjusting to what Silver Savage is throwing at them. They've adjusted to Jaxter. They've adjusted to Rolls Royce. And they're doing a great job of just protecting Carl a lot more than Silver Savages has been protecting Skies.
Yeah, Skies has gone down quite a bit. And despite all that, they actually managed to get the point back. But Carl has roughly 20% advantage, kind of dwindling, but it's going to be very tough for them to keep control of this point. Corsa is on a 6K right now, taking out Lazy, and just hanging on by a thread right now is Silver Savages, and we should be seeing a push come through soon. Actually, the Skies is up on a Kritzkrieg, so they're going to go with this right away. Invader sends it off, took down Huey Lewis, trying to find some more, but the counter pop came out of Carl. He was able to get Patty as well, and a lot of frags coming through from Silver Savages. They might be able to hold this point off, possibly. It's going to be... Oh, no!
It's going to be a thing that a dog has on its legs.
Oh, that was good. Oh, good meme there, Grizz. I like it.
You know, a lot of people say that when you get older, your memes, you know, they go down in quality. But I beg to differ. I think memes are like a fine wine. They get better
with
age.
Right, they really do. You know what? I think I'm going to do a communication student. I want to do like a study on that, like an internet study. You know, do some good academic research on quality of memes over time. As age increases, might follow up on your hypothesis there. I don't know. As you can tell, we're just trying to fill some time here by talking about memes, and that's of course what the kids are into nowadays, isn't it, Grizz?
Yeah. You know, it really. I'm seeing Twitch chat here. I'm seeing a lot of support for me. So thank you guys. getting a lot. Yeah. Pause. P A W S. Thank you, Smobo. And of course, Mason, always very supportive throughout my entire TF2 career. Mario, Lemon Pulp. Yep, these are the names that got me to love the game.
All right. Well, sorry about that, guys. Had some technical difficulties back on our end, but if you caught back with us just in time there, Silver Savages just made a brilliant hold to the point to actually make this a 2-2 game right at the end there. That was crucial for them. They've tied it up now, so it's going to be a push to see who can take the lead going into the half here. No, it's been very tight so far, but a great hold from them nonetheless, from Silver Savages, to come through and win that round. So we're going to go right into it here. Carl is so hurt over on the cliffside, desperately trying to heal up right now. And just a lot of guys hurt on the side of DK, so Silver Savages is going to grab the point first here.
Unfortunately, I think that pause was actually called because Mooma dropped, which was, you know, a super unfortunate time for that to happen. Probably helped SS win, but I mean, I loved how SS just played that mid very aggressive, really got a train, aka Godwash, a lot of room to move around. Carl goes down to a bomb, or sticky bomb from Invader. Nice job, as blue team is going to pop and try and get some ground and get some frags as Sentry Guns and Huey Lewis all go down.
Yeah, that was really big stuff from Invader, able to get Carl there, so. They're going to have to go back to the drawing board here, DK, and, you know, going into this, I thought just because of the type of talent that DK had, I thought they were going to be able to, you know, take this, not easily, but Silver Savages is really hanging tight with him here. Banny got in, got a lot of good damage off on the skis, and if he isn't careful, he's going to go down to rollers, and Mooma was actually able to find three frags, and Vader got the old bottle kill on the patty, but DK has yet to cap up. Actually, now Mooma's finishing off the cap. So they're going to come through now. They got all their respawns much quicker since they hadn't capped that point. So they got guys coming through, and now Silver Savages waiting for theirs. And Carl will have a slight advantage here to work with. Not much, though.
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised at how well DK has been playing. I start talking, and every time, I just spy frag just right on top of it. So excellent job by Akuma, just obliterating skis there with a great backstab. But yeah, as I was saying earlier, DK looking pretty polished for a team that's undergone a bunch of switches within their roster. I don't really know what's caused it, but I have heard rumors that they've been switching rosters, you know, almost every scrim and getting people, but it seems to have worked out for them because it looks like they're playing pretty strong right now.
Now they really are. They're hanging in tight, but, you know, Silver Savages is also playing quite a game here. As the Uber has popped off from DK, they send forward. Invaders down, Jaxter, Traylan as well. And Skeez is going to go down to Patty, actually, as he got in for the frag. So Skeez has really been, I feel as though I see Skeez go down much more than Carl. But as I say that, Carl had also gone down on the post Uber, so Silver Savages came out on top of the fight. They're going to grab the point, and they're just going to be chilling.
Yeah, nice collapse from SS at the end of that Uber, doing a great job of, you know, after both Ubers were popped, they had great positioning, able to come in and pick up the frag on Carl and get themselves the point. Doing a nice job of getting the things that really matter, obviously point presence, which is a lot of teams at this level have great DM, but kind of forget about what the real objective is.
exactly. There's definitely much more to this than DM. Course is going to win the sniper battle, I should say, on Pharaoh after there. And DK gets control of the point once again. Carl has a little bit of advantage to work with here. They do have it. Ski's taking a lot of damage there behind Rock. Didn't quite go down. Actually, Carl was able to, I think, get some crits off. I'm not sure if all that much was found with it. And the counter pop is now going to come through from... Ooh, excuse me once again. Silver Savages. And they got the point for now.
Silver Savages, again, a nice little fight there, maintaining control of the point. Dealing with a little bit of harass here from Mooma as he just looks for some more ambi headshots, which seems to be what both of these spies are gunning for tonight.
Well, they're hanging out, and DK's looking to make a move back towards the point, and Kuma's lurking behind Skies right now. It's a good opportunity. He's going to take him down again. That's a few for a Kuma on the night. On to Skies. He's got his number right now, as well as a couple other players on the side of DK. But brilliant frag there. Nobody around watching the back of the combo, and DK should have a pretty easy time of taking control of this point here, and it helps when you have Corsa popping off heads like Invader. And Patty's gonna die if he doesn't get some heals really quick. Oh, goodness! All right, he got healed, so we're good. DK's got the point. They need to make up for a lot of lost time here, though, Grizz.
Yeah, I mean, they're at a time deficit, but again, they just picked Skies. They've got Uber advantage. Carl knows how to play this map. I wouldn't be too frightened if you're a DK fan or a player on DK right here. I think this is looking pretty comfortable for them as long as they don't get forced in a really weird position.
They have a nice little forward hold going here, too. They have Mooma, Banny, and Carl, as well as Huey Lewis coming in. Ooh, Carl's gonna get blasted up into the air, taken down to really low health, and actually got finished off by Jaxter. Oh, good stuff. That's exactly what Silver Savages needed. Jaxter's gonna find Huey Lewis as well. That's a 3K from him coming out of the spawn. And now that will be DK on the ropes, because Silver Savages is gonna be able to come onto this point. They should get this cap, and they also have a full Uber advantage. DK needs to work extremely quickly. Mooma comes in off a cliff trying to get some damage out. I think that Uber did get popped off from Skies, but the frags just continue to ring through here on the side of Silver Savages. Now Mooma's down, Patty and Jordan, and nobody on the point as he had to stand on it. Carl just barely got onto it, but they're losing players left and right, DK. Looks like it should be a Silver Savages round here. Indeed it is. They take a 3-2 lead at the half, man. They are playing big when it counts, Grizz.
Yeah, I mean, that forward hold looked like a good idea. They just weren't really ready, didn't have the time to react to Jaxter. We got a great bomb in there, two good rockets onto Carl. So, I mean, that's just the danger that you have to be ready for when you're having that aggressive forward hold. You know, when it works, it really works. And when it doesn't, you're in a lot of trouble. It's not a very forgiving strategy.
Yeah, that was tough. You know, he was trying to try and hold that Uber if he could, Carl, but nonetheless, Jaxter still making a great play there, and really, I think that was kind of the pivotal point in the round for Silver Savages. It pretty much allowed them to win it. They had they had Skies then with a full advantage that they could just hold point with, and that puts them at a 3-2 lead going into halftime here. So all they need is one more round, but if we take a look at just, I mean, sheer points on the scoreboard here, Godwash has just been, just going nuts in this game as far as points are concerned.
Yeah, I mean, looking over at the logs, which I can't really throw them into Twitch chat. I don't have the power to do that. But I will say Godwash with 52 frags, a.k.a. Train, just doing so much work. Not quite as much damage as I would have expected. In fact, Banny actually having a little bit more DPM. But again, both snipers, non-surprisingly, at the top of the kill list. 51 frags for Pharaoh Affer and 48 from Corsa. Big numbers, but again, two great snipers on a sniper-friendly map. You know, both doing tons of work, but sort of canceling each other out.
Yeah, Pharaoh Affer got off to a really hot start, I should say, over first couple of rounds, and then, you know, we had Corsa really start to come back and find his legs throughout the rest of the game and was able to compete with Pharaoh Affer throughout it. So it just took a little bit of time to warm up, but definitely found his game over time. But still, despite that, we see Silver Savages with a 3-2 lead. Could you possibly send me that log or whatever
it is? In Twitch.
Awesome.
Another number. I mean, I love stats. I love me some spreadsheets. And one number that is sticking out right at me right now is the 8 medic picks from Invader. It really, I mean, casting, I didn't notice it, but yeah, great work from Invader getting the pressure onto Carl in those post Uber fights, cleaning him up, doing tons of damage, had a couple good bombs in there as well. And of course, Akuma with 6 picks. I want to say he had, I don't know how many drops he had because your stats don't have, but excellent job picking up 15 backstabs, 35 headshots, 39 headshots from Rolls Royce. So, yeah, I mean, Spy is doing a ton of gun work in this match.
I didn't even realize Invader had so many med frags. Like you said, that's it's pretty crazy. But nonetheless, that's some really big stuff for the return frags. Because I felt as though Skies was going down quite a bit, and the deaths actually show that Carl had gone down more than Skies, which surprised me. I don't know. Maybe I was just catching it every time that Skies went down, but it would make sense considering Silver Savage is in the lead currently. But we should hopefully continue to see some great TF2, because it has just been so back and forth here. I mean, I think every round has been pretty close for the most part. Most of them coming down to, you know, like 10 seconds left in the round or something between the teams trying to battle it out. So it's really been a great showing at TF2 so far. Definitely showing why it's been such an anticipated match to see. And, you know, hopefully we see that continued there. But really, these, like you were saying, these snipers are just going off. Corsa and Pharaoh Affer both sitting at above 400 DPM. A lot of frags, too. So it's been just a great showing of skill here so far this evening, Grizz.
Yeah, I mean, looking at the stats, it's really hard to pick out players who you say, you know, I expect better from them. Obviously, I would like to see a little bit more from Jaxter and Patty, but at this level, you know, great work from the combos defending from those big soldier bombs. Jaxter's had some success. Patty's had some really nice plays. But, you know, in this second half, I would really like to see them, you know, turn it up a notch, get those big plays onto the medic like Jaxter had in that last round. So, yeah, we'll see that. And, of course, Jordan, a.k.a. Uncle Dane, a.k.a. that meme's old, doing well as well.
Yeah, he is actually. He's sitting at, what is that, like 30 frags, I believe? Or yeah, 30 frags, yeah, which is great, really. And speaking of Jaxter's soldier play, he's also got 5 med picks, so no, he doesn't have like loads of frags or anything. I mean, he's sitting, you know, kind of average, 24 or so, but he's gotten 5 med picks, which is, I believe that's the second most on the side of Silver Savages. Other than Invader, so definitely being a presence out there, Jaxter is for sure. It got that one drop too, which is definitely one of the biggest to note, I believe. Really allowed Silver Savages to get themselves back into the round and win this half here, going up 3-2. So they only need one more, but you know, it's just going to be a matter of can DK find their legs here, kind of get back into it. So time will tell, as they say, and we see kind of players are dropping in and out of the server here. I'm not sure what the problem is, but hopefully we can get started and finish this off sometime tonight here, Grizz. I'm hoping. I'm praying.
I mean, I'm hoping it finishes tonight. If it finishes tomorrow, you might lose me, but
yeah.
I'm excited. This is pretty much as good a game as I would expect to see coming out of these two teams. I'm pleasantly surprised with how SS is doing. You know, when I really stopped playing the game, they were kind of up and coming, and it's good to see them kind of getting to that top tier level team. And seeing these players like Train, you know, Invader, you know, Skies, all these players really come up from the lower divisions and finally make it to the top of Platinum.
Yeah, definitely making making a name for themselves here, being able to put up such a putting up such a tough fight against DK here. But while we have a little bit of time, you guys head on over to evl.gg. You can check out the shirts that are being made for the production staff and other people that work over at EVL, you know, producers, casters, all that kind of thing. You can head over there, evl.gg. As I said, pick up a shirt from around $18 to $20, directly supports the casters and producers of which you buy their shirt. So, with that being said, we are headed into the second half. Silver Savages up 3-2 at the moment. They just need one more round and they can finish off this game and take the win over DK. We'll see if they're able to do so, though. Already quite a few frags coming across for Silver Savages. They've lost Zan, Corsa, Akuma, oh, the whole lot of them. They're just dropping like flies right now. Carl managed to stay alive, did get himself all the way back to spawn, but commanding mid there from Silver Savages.
Yeah, again, that really aggressive mid play that we saw in the last two rounds working out really well for SS. DK having a hard time adjusting to it. Again, it's doing exactly what SS wants. They want to free train up. They want to let him just DM around the map. And the best way to do that is just to clear off mid, make sure to get rid of that mini sentry, and just let him run the show. It's what was letting Banny be more successful in the beginning rounds, and it's what is allowing Train to do so much work now.
And the Ubers are going to be exchanged here on point. Not really many frags coming through, just a lot of everybody kind of stuffing their faces into each other, really. But DK pretty strong on the point right now. Akuma comes up from behind, skis, takes him down. He actually found two backstabs, got Traylan, and oh my goodness, he's going to get the headshot, the ambi headshot on the Godwash as well. He goes off right there, getting three frags, two big backstabs, one of which was on the skis and the ambi headshot. Can't ask for too much more out of your spy there, Grizz.
That is what a star player looks like, and those are the big plays that turn games around. Akuma just destroying the combo of SS, and as you said, getting a great pick onto Train, who's been a problem for DK throughout the whole match.
Yeah, a brilliant ambi headshot, nonetheless, too, doing it in style. So, DK's going to be able to maintain this point for a little while thanks to those great frags from Akuma, but Silver Savage is looking to come back in here and grab this point maybe if they can. Carl's just about to come up on the Uber. Ski still has just a few more percent until they get it. They're going to send it forward, see maybe if they can catch him off guard quickly, but Ski's got it in time, and they got a flash invader here. He might get dropped. They did manage to keep him alive, but he's still quite hurt. And he's going to have to back up. DK is looking to aggress right back onto this point and take it from Silver Savages. Invader went down to a body shot from Corsa. So DK's got the point. Silver Savage is content with just hanging back for now.
Yeah, nice job by Corsa being pretty ballsy there. Got some nice headshots off at very low health. But he did go down there to a rocket. So Farrowhafer has a little bit of freedom taking down Zan. Akuma, though, returns the favor, taking down Blue Heavy as well.
Akuma's been a giant presence for DK so far here in this half. But when we take a look, the Uber is going to get popped out from DK here. Banny getting sent forward, trying to take down Skis. He was able to get him with the pistol, finish off that frag. And you gotta, that's a force to be reckoned with when you have an Ubered Banny running at you across the map. It's a pretty scary sight, Grizz.
Yeah, indeed it is. That great pistol aim, able to take him down. Pretty much what we expect from Banny at this point. Great DM. But again, it looks like DK seems to have found a little bit of a groove here, getting some nice one-on-one plays. Banny and Akuma both doing great work this round. And of course, Mooma putting in tons of damage, opening up the opportunities. But Train does not want to be outshone and gets a two-frag of his own.
Indeed he does, and Silver Savages are able to grab the point here. So once again, we are seeing a very, very close round, staying tight throughout the game. And Uber's relatively even here, just about dead even, actually. And it looks like DK, I see Froyo Banny's name. DK looking to make a move forward here, and both Ubers are going to get exchanged on the point. SS has it for the time being, but DK's looking to make a move. They're down three guys on Silver Savages right now. DK losing a lot of people. They gotta try and back up if they can in time. Carl went down though. Mooma should fall here as well. He's hanging on just barely. There's the flare to finish it off from Lazy. So Silver Savages, they might be able to solidify a win here soon, Grizz.
Yeah, great job by Lazy. Saw a combo that was unprotected, just jumped right on him with that scorch shot, tearing him up. Great work by Lazy with the heads up pyro play there.
Ooh, just 30 seconds left. They have a lot of advantage here on the side of Silver Savages, but you know, we'll have to. Oh no, Akuma has he's lurking in behind Skies once again here. Good opportunity, takes down Skies. Akuma once again making the big plays. DK desperately needed a play like that to come out of Akuma, and they've got it, so they gotta get going with it right now. As Rolls Royce came in though and got the counter frag on the Carl. It's back and forth between these two spies right here. Oh my goodness, DK desperately needs to do something to try and get this point back. Course is on it, doing whatever he can. Got the frag on the Lazy, who is air blasting him back, but in the end got taken out. Silver Savages is going to win the game 4-2. Holy crap, Grizz. That was some good TF2.
Well, wow, I can confidently say that was not Akuma's fault that they lost that game. Made an unbelievable amount of plays in that game. Did everything to keep him in it. And in the end, SS, great point presence. Nice pushes there. Won a couple of key Uber v Uber fights. And, of course, Rolls Royce with a nice stab on Carl at the end there. So,
man, that's exactly what you want to see in a game of TF2. That was awesome. Akuma, especially in that second half, was just going off. Found so many crucial med picks and various other picks, really. And just, you know, the rest of DK couldn't really get it going. As you said, can't blame Akuma there. He made brilliant plays throughout the game, especially on that second half. So that leaves Silver Savages with the win. I just, due to the names that were on DK at the start of this game, kind of as I was saying before, you know, I had higher hopes for them, but Silver Savages showed what they were made of tonight, man. That's a big win for them, taking down DK 4-2 here on Viaduct. So they are going to have a lot of confidence moving forward, I would say.
Yeah, excited to see the rest of the season. Great game tonight, and as always, it's been a pleasure casting with GX.
It has been. It has been a pleasure. It's good to get back into the Mumble channel with you back on stream, since it has been a while. Hopefully I'll see you again at some point throughout the season. I know you kind of been lurking a little bit, not around as much as before, but hopefully we see you back here at some point, Grizz. But anyway, that we're going to shut things down for the night. One more time, head on over to evl.gg. Check out the shirts on the website there. Anywhere from about $18 to $20 or so, you can buy a shirt of a name that you like, one of the guys that are working, you know, with EVL, whether it be a caster, producer, whatever it may be, support our man Dashner here. He's the guy that's producing for us tonight. You can buy one of his shirts, directly supports him as well as the rest of EVL. So definitely check that out, EVL.gg. But
buy a Dashner shirt. That's all I can say, man.
Yeah, getting that in there. But anyway, that's going to do it for us, guys. Thanks for tuning in over here on EVL TV. For myself, Gex, Grizz, and Dashner, our wonderful producer who loves us so much, we say goodnight to you guys, and we will see you next time.